We'll now call this meeting to order. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Commissioner Dyer?
Here.
Commissioner Kane?
Here.
Commissioner Nash?
Here.
Commissioner Betteridge?
Here.
Commissioner Young?
Here.
Deputy Director McDonald?
Here.
Director Capelli?
Here. Adequate notice of this meeting has been provided in accordance with the Open Public Meetings Act. I'll now ask for everyone to rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Mr. Angelella?
Pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the Republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
For me, all but that.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the meeting of the Camden County Board of Commissioners. The next order of business is the minutes of our previous meetings. Motion to accept the minutes as presented.
So moved.
Is there a second? Roll call.
Commissioner Dyer?
Yes.
Commissioner Kane?
Yes.
Commissioner Nash?
Yes.
Commissioner Betteridge?
Yes.
Commissioner Young?
Yes.
Deputy Director McDonald?
Yes.
Director Capelli?
Yes. Next is the Comptroller's Report. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Commissioner Dyer?
Yes.
Commissioner Kane?
Yes.
Commissioner Nash? Commissioner Betteridge?
Yes.
Commissioner Young?
Yes.
Deputy Director McDonald?
Yes.
Director Capelli?
Yes. Do we have any correspondences, Madam Clerk?
We do not this month, Director.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the next portion of the meeting is open to the public for discussion of resolutions to be acted upon this afternoon. There'll be another public hearing later in the meeting at which members of the public can ask any questions they want regarding the business of Camden County. This portion is limited to discussion of those resolutions to be acted upon. I now declare this public hearing open.
Director, I see no questions at this time.
Seeing no one, move to close.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Public hearing is closed. Ladies and gentlemen, our caucus on Tuesday, the Board of Commissioners reviewed the resolutions to be acted upon this afternoon. It was at that time that the board discussed items to be voted on. We will now be voting on resolutions in blocks based on the unanimous consent of the commissioners. We'll be voting on resolutions 1 through 86. Is there a motion on resolutions 1 through 86?
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Commissioner Dyer?
Yes. Yes to all.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm hungry.
Commissioner Dyer?
Yes, but abstaining from 29.
Commissioner Kane?
Yes to all.
Commissioner Nash?
Yes, but I'll abstain on numbers 59, 75, and 85.
Commissioner Betteridge?
Yes to all.
Commissioner Young?
Yes, but I will abstain from 20, 21, 74, and 75.
Deputy Director McDonald?
Yes, I'll abstain on numbers 74 and 75.
Director Capelli?
Yes, but I'll abstain on 3, 4, 59, 77, and 85. Is your resolution for 87? Hearing no motions, that resolution does not pass. At this time, this board public meeting is open to any member of the public who wishes to address the board.
Seeing none. I will ask that the motion to close.
Second.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Public hearing is closed. At this time, we will open the floor to members of the Board of Commissioners for their comments. We'll begin with Commissioner Nash.
Thank you. Happy July 4th, everyone.
Thank you. Commissioner Young.
Thank you, Director. I'd like to say thank you to all our county employees. Just a couple of quick announcements. Our county fair and sustainability festival is Saturday and Sunday, the 24th and 25th of June from 1 to 7. And the one stop, we are happy to announce that the Youth Summer Employment Program is starting before the end of June, and approximately 50 Camden County youth will be being placed with local businesses throughout the county. And of course, don't forget our Juneteenth at Wiggins Front Park, the 17th on Saturday, starting at 2 o'clock. Come on down. Thank you very much, everybody. Have a great weekend.
Thank you, Commissioner King.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to thank everyone for being here. And I just wanted to update that the county had a wonderful and meaningful Memorial Day program on the Battleship New Jersey this year. And it was very, very well attended. And as I said, it was very, very meaningful and appreciated by all in attendance. We completed the flagging of 30,000 graves within Camden County. And we are also having volunteers that unfortunately have to go back and remove the flags. And I thank all who have banded together to do these tasks. Yesterday on the Battleship New Jersey, we had a medal ceremony, which was great. It was also Flag Day yesterday and the 248th birthday of the US Army. And I believe we had 9 Camden County residents who were in attendance receiving various medals. And Commissioner Betteridge was there along with Ross, Mr. Angelella was there. And just hearing their bios was really incredible. Some of the work that these veterans have done in their service to our country. And the medal ceremony was just the least we could do to thank them for their dedication to the US. And to thank the staff of the Camden County Veterans Affairs and not the quiet work of the Veterans Service Officers who are filing claims for many, many residents, bringing in millions of dollars and medical assistance to our veterans. On a different note, Memorial Day weekend, the day before the weekend started, we had the Camden County Teen Arts Festival, which is part of the State Arts Festival. We had 350 students participating. It was held at the Camden County College of Blackwood, and there were students there participating in musical theater, dance, visual arts, filmmaking, and really a lot, tremendous talent within the county. And looking forward this summer to the Senior Arts Festival, also with a lot of talented artists, some of whom will be participating, and they will be celebrating their 105th birthday at the same time. So, thank you.
Thank you. Great work, Commissioner. Commissioner Dyer.
Thank you, Director. I've always wanted to thank the Camden County workforce for the tremendous job they do for our citizens in Camden County. I want to thank the leadership team. We have 12 projects in Camden right now valued at $88 million, and we have 28 projects going on in Camden County at a value of $29 million. And I segue to that. We want to recognize Fred Henry. He's been working for DBW for 45 years. He's responsible for the maintenance of the complex. Fred always does a wonderful job. He's willing to do whatever it takes. And we are truly lucky to have him down there. So let's give Fred Henry a shout out. I'm in a given mood today. I want to thank Commissioner Ed McDonald for the support he has, for the continuous support of the Lark School. As a commissioner, that's one of my favorite events, Mr. Softy Ice Cream Day. And I'm down to only eating 4 cones at this event, but it's truly great for you to keep recognizing the Lark School. Thank you for that. Shameless plug today as well. We've been recognizing a lot of athletes throughout Camden County and, you know, basketball and football athletes, and I always try to spread it out to make sure that everybody knows that we have a well-rounded South Jersey Camden County athletic community. Pensacola Boys Track and Field has won the state championship in indoor and outdoor track this year. Has not been recognized. So I feel bad because I should, living in Pensacola and living in Camden County, we can't remiss that. That is a tremendous feat for a team to win the indoor and outdoor. They have 2 All-Americans on the team. They'll be competing in the meet of champion this evening. And they won the state champion last week for Group 4 Boys Track and Field. And the girls are not shabby either. They broke their school record in a 4x4. My daughter's on that team. It's comprised of 2 sophomore and 2 freshmen. I'll be leaving here shortly to go up to North Jersey this evening. They'll be competing in the meet of champions for Group 4 4x4 this evening. So I will be there recognizing that. And finally, we have the 5th annual Hassan Reddick Youth Football Camp this Saturday. We had over 400 kids registered thus far. We had to cut the registration off. We probably anticipating another 200 at the gate. So this is probably one of the largest camps we've done for him. I want to thank Frank and Kara for a tremendous job they do with helping us with this event. And this truly has become an annual event, and every year it has grown. We had a lot of kids last year, and it's just getting better. And I also want to, in closing out, we have a Juneteenth celebration at the Camden Waterfront this Saturday and this weekend as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Betteridge.
Thank you. Thank you, Director. Very busy end of May and beginning of June. On May 23rd, I had the opportunity to attend the Youth Services Commission I was taken by the efforts of the commission and to honor a young woman that was on a track that wasn't going to be favorable for her. With the hard work, and Rosie Arroyo is here, of Rosie and the team, this young woman received a laptop and encouragement and is now going to attend a school to become a nurse.
Oh, great.
And it was just a testament to the hard work and dedication that everyone does in Camden County to help the youth of our community. On May 24th, we honored the COVID-19 volunteers at Appreciation Day at Camden County College. On June 1st, I attended the senior day at the Camden driving range. It was great to see about 20 of our seniors come out, and really, I mean, I didn't hit the ball, but they were hitting the ball. So it was really nice to get to know them and to share some of the their questions and answers that they have on what we're doing as county representatives. On June 5th, I had the pleasure to attend the Puerto Rican flag raising at Wiggins Park. This is a month-long celebration that is being hosted and provided by the Parada San Juan. And with that, I will yield to you, Director.
Oh, thank you. Deputy Director McDonald.
Thank you, Director. Just very quickly, I want to thank all the employees of Camden County, of course, for the great work they do every day. And also especially thank them for the Mr. Softy truck coming to Lark School. It's such a thrill for the 125 kids with disabilities. It's a wonderful day they look forward to. I especially thank Karen, Bob, and Dominic, who kind of coordinate it, but it's all supplied by the employees of Camden County. It is their funds which pay for this. So we're very, very grateful to all of them. Thank you.
Thank you. I too would like to thank the employees of Camden County for the great work they do day in and day out on behalf of our residents. And with that, I will take a motion to adjourn.
So moved.